Tarrant County's judge says school districts and youth organizations should consider putting sports back on hold as the number of COVID cases surge in the county. Our Caroline Vandergriff explaining why he can't order sports to shut down, though.
Thousands of kids returned to fields and courts this summer and fall.
Some of them are still doing virtual learning, and so this is their really only opportunity to socialize with kids their own age, with their friends, and just get out and do something healthy and not be stuck inside all day.
But Tarrant County Judge Glenn Whitley is calling for a timeout on youth sports, with coronavirus cases in the county nearing their summer peak.
And I think if you can, if you can put that on hold for 6 months or so, or just, you know, then I think that can make a big difference.
Multiple football and volleyball games across North Texas have been canceled or postponed because of student athletes or coaches testing positive for COVID-19. Right now, about a quarter of Aledo High School's freshman and varsity teams are being quarantined after potential exposure to the virus.
We have some knuckleheads in our community and in our school and on our coaching staff.
Judge Whitley says he's seen parents and spectators in the bleachers not wearing masks or social distancing.
I truly believe that that's a big part of the reason that we're having the spread right now.
But the YMCA of Fort Worth says those safety protocols are strictly enforced at all their events. The organization just wrapped up an 8-week soccer season with more than 1,000 kids with no COVID interruptions.
The safety protocols are tough. They're tough on everyone, but they're there to protect us, and they're there to make sure that we don't see youth sports cause a rise of the virus in our community.
Judge Whitley doesn't actually have the authority to stop sports. That's covered by the governor's executive order. He does have a call tomorrow with school districts and cities to talk about possibly extending Tarrant County's mask order, which is set to expire at the end of this month. Caroline Vandergriff, CBS 11 News.